So we are here with Mr. Julien Dufour with Verifavia Shipping. It's a very innovative, let's say, company which is capitalizing on the new regulations, if I'm allowed to use that word, regarding the CO2 emissions from shipping. So Mr. Dufour, let me give us a short brief about what Verifavia offers to shipping companies.
Verifavia offers a complete range of EU MRV solution for shipping companies. Shipping companies are concerned by the regulation called EU MRV for monitoring, reporting, verification of emission, fuel consumption, transport work and energy efficiency parameters of large ships exceeding 5,000 gross tonnage, calling at an EU port for commercial purposes. It's a regulation called the Regulation 2015-757 that came into force last year. It was proposed by the European Commission and turned into force in July 2015 with a gradual implementation starting with the submission of monitoring plan in August next year, August 2017, and monitoring a number of emissions and fuel consumption and transport work in 2018. Preparation of emission report beginning of 2019, verification of the emission report by an accredited independent verification body, submission of the emission report to the flag state and the commission, and final step, the delivery of the document of compliance that every ship must carry on board starting from June 2019. The document of compliance is like a license to trade, license to operate in EU waters.
Is there some sort of panic among ship owners regarding what should they do about these new monitoring systems?
I would not say there is panic, but there should be panic, because it's really coming soon. It entered into force about a year ago. It's been on the pipeline for several years. It's now entered into force. It's going to be implemented. It's being implemented. It's not rocket science, but there are things to be done. IT systems to be adapted, data to be collected, training, processes. So it's there is work to do for companies to be compliant. And about 95% plus of the regulation, of the technical rules of the regulation, have been defined, either at the working group level or legally. So it's actually possible to start MRV now. There's no need to wait until next year.
Absolutely.
It's possible to start tomorrow. There is enough information available for companies to start monitoring. There is enough information for verifiers to start verifying. And there is enough information for national accreditation bodies to provide the accreditation to verify.
Is there a standard procedure which will be used, like the emission cycle in automobiles, or is it something totally different?
Totally different.
There are four acceptable fuel consumption monitoring methodologies. So they call method A, B, C, and D. A is the use of BDN, B is the use of fuel tank monitoring, C is the use of fuel flow meter, and D is the use of direct emission measurement equipment system.
Okay, so is the EU implementing any, all of them at the same time? They
yes.
will accept all of them?
They will accept all of them. It's up to each.
Per emission source.
Per emission source. There could be a combination of methodologies if this increases the overall accuracy of the measurements.
Okay.
But it's up to each shipping company to decide which fuel consumption monitoring methodology it wants to use for this ship.
In terms of additional cost, how would you estimate this will be in terms of actual cost for a ship owner?
That's difficult to define, because there is no market yet for this kind of service, and it also depends on the complexity of the MRV accounting system, and depends on the number of vessels, the size of the fleet, whether it's automatic or manual data entry.
But the locations of the head offices, if you have three head offices or just one head office, and all that.
But it will be in a range of, say, 800, 1,000, 1,200 euro per ship, or something between 600 and 1,000 euro per ship,
okay.
per annum.
On an annual basis?
On an annual basis.
Okay. Recently you announced a very interesting agreement with Neda Maritime from Greece. Can you give us a bit of details on that?
Yes, last year Neda Maritime contracted Verifavia Shipping to conduct what we call a pre-verification gap analysis, which is an audit, conformity audit, conformity checks of their procedures against the requirements laid down in the EU MRV regulation. So what we did, we visited them, we reviewed the documents, we observed the IT systems, we checked their data, we interviewed the people in charge of the process, and we identified all the gaps between their procedures and the requirements of the regulation. They closed those gaps. They also prepared an emission report that we verified, an emission report that was prepared in accordance with the requirements of regulation. They also prepared a monitoring plan, which was also completed according to the requirement of regulation that we also assessed. And because they are able to produce one emission, one monitoring plan that's complying with the regulation, one emission report that complies with the regulation, their procedures comply with the regulation, so we consider them to be MRV ready. We provided them with an MRV ready certificate, and they are now one of the first Greek shipping companies to be MRV ready and to be ready for the regulation.
Do you think that this, let's say, case study, which is almost like a case study, will be, let's say, viral, to use a popular word? Will it catch up with other ship owners?
We hope so.
We've seen evidence of that.
What's the feedback so far from Posidonia?
Everybody's wondering what MRV is because they're lacking the specifics. We have even heard stories that MRV is a tax on shipping. It is not a tax on shipping.
Okay.
It is a tax on carbon. And carbon has begun being taxed for the past 10-15 years, whether we're talking about industry, heavy industry, road transport is coming, aviation, of course, since Verifavia Shipping. Verifavia is currently number one in the world when it comes to aviation, MRV, monitoring, review and verification and surrender. So shipping is an industry that was, as Julien said, it was under discussion for a long time. And slowly and gradually, ship owners and operators, as well as ICT providers and solution providers, they want to really understand what MRV is. What is a voyage according to MRV? What are the emission sources according to MRV and all that? So we feel that they want to start getting ready. And slowly they have also begun to understand that they're not that far away anyway. A big part of what the process requires is already being done. It's just that we need some house cleaning, a little bit of spring cleaning, sorting out the process, defining certain actions. And once this is done, then it's just going to be an annual recurring thing similar to your car insurance. It will just happen every year, and it will be as simple as that. Unless there is a dramatic change, of course, like a huge addition to the fleet or a huge decline of the fleet. Other than that, everything is going to remain.
And a ship owner has every interest in having a ship fuel efficient vessels as well.
Absolutely. Once we allow a couple of years to sort of evolve, then we will be able to have very meaningful results that will, at the end of the day, work for the shipping operators' benefit, like very good benchmarking within their own fleet, or benchmarking of a certain type of fleet vis-a-vis the rest of the same type of vessels. So the conclusions will be drawn, and efficient ways of working and modus operandi will be created as a byproduct of the EU MRV shipping regulation.
And which countries are you able to service at the moment?
Sorry?
Which countries are you able to service at the moment?
We can service any country. The accreditation is a European-wide accreditation, and the accreditation allows a verifier, an accredited, independent accredited verifier, to verify any ship worldwide that has to comply with the regulation.
And how long does it take for each ship to be verified?
That's basically our competitive advantage, if you like. The way Verifavia Shipping operates, which is a virtual, sort of efficient and lean structure, allows us not only to accommodate whatever has to do with the investment associated with that, but also have processes and procedures that are seamless, bases the fact that we are committing not to sort of create any trouble for the ship owner. Usually no more than a week.
It actually depends, of course, on the level of readiness
always
of the shipping company. But if the shipping company is ready, if they have the monitoring plan, the data, the emission report in place, then it's a matter of a couple of days. We always ensure almost immediate turnaround, and we try to always strive to work in the most efficient way, most efficient and flexible way.
So we'll be seeing you in the future Posidonia as well, from what we can determine.
Absolutely, we're already getting ready for Posidonia 2018.
Exactly.
Thank you very much to the both.
Thank you very much
for having us. And whatever information is required in order to demystify, because we decided that that's probably the most accurate word to use, the MRV regulation, Verifavia Shipping is here to answer any questions that may come up.
Thank you very much.
And we organize during Posidonia MRV masterclasses every day at 11:30 and 3 p.m. until Friday.
Sure.
And it's an opportunity to learn about MRV, to ask questions, and to demystify the regulation.
Exactly. They are free to attend.
At the booth 1148.
Exactly.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for having us. And all the best for Posidonia 2016.
You too. All the best.